basketball. Tonight, it'll be Chicago going up against the Spurs. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. DA will join us tonight on the sideline. So with Smith sitting on the bench, this is the group Mike Malone has right now. McDaniel is out there with LeBron James. Then there's a follow. Then it's Morant. And it's Cauley-Stein in at center, locking down the middle. And for San Antonio, the four and the five, it's Johnson and Poeltl. Jones is out there with Devin Vassell. And it's McDermott in at the small forward position. Now, here's Johnson. Here's Poeltl. It's tipped. And that's out of bounds. San Antonio will retain possession. Just two to shoot. And Greg, Kelvin Johnson is listed at 6'5", but he plays much bigger than him.
He has the strength to fight for rebounds with anybody. Fearless on the court and plays with an endless motor. His strength and willingness to use it makes him valuable.
Here's Jones after Chicago picking up a basket just moments ago. And the basket by Vassell.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Vassell with it, now guarded by Alfonso. Here's Jones, got a piece of it. Here's McDaniel. Shoots over McDermott. Here's Cauley-Stein, good for the basket, starting off one for one with that shot.
And with his vertical reach, you expect Cauley-Stein to be a factor on the offensive glass.
Poked loose, and that's out of bounds. San Antonio will retain possession. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Here's Chicago. A follow, the pass to James. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. It's over McDermott. James misses. They get a hand on it. Hi and welcome everyone here on 2K Sports. Can't wait to get some NBA action going. Alongside Greg Anthony and Steve Smith, with David Aldridge on the sideline, this is Kevin Harlan. So with Smith sitting on the bench, this is the group Mike Malone has right now. McDaniel is out there with LeBron James. Then there's a Aflalo. Then there's Cauley-Stein. And it's Morant in at the one. And for the Spurs, the four and the five, it's Johnson and Poeltl. Jones is out there with Devin Vassell. And it's McDermott in at the three, the small forward.
Really solid from deep. You have to stay connected to Johnson or he'll hurt you.
You know, Steve, the persistent growth of Keldon Johnson is pretty impressive.
It is, Kevin. He is obviously receptive to good coaching and is committed to finding success here in the league. Almost across the board, you see his stats creeping up season to season.
And it's Morant. That time on the assist by Aflalo.
Keep track of Ja, especially when he's in transition. He shows you right there.
And you love seeing that great mobile one drive a second time.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Jones passes it to McDermott from past the arc. McDaniel grabs the miss. And Morant's got the ball here for Chicago. They get it again. Here's James. Cauley-Stein trying to free himself up. Nice shot by James.
He's one of those guys who is extra difficult to block out. When LeBron really wants a rebound, it's hard to beat him to the ball.
Now here's Jones. McDermott kicks to Vassell. And there's the pass to Johnson. Shot from 12. Chicago grabs the miss. Morant scanning the floor. Cauley-Stein. Good, and a nice assist from Morant.
This is what I like about Ja Morant. He stays open to all options. Right there finds the open man.
Jones, the pass to Berger. Ball's knocked loose and stolen by Cauley Stein. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
Give him a hand, fans. Your dance team.
To McDermott, back to Jones. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Back to McDermott, Johnson in the corner. 5 to shoot, and they get it. No good on that one, and it's Chicago the other way. Here's LeBron, and the dunk by James.
And don't look now, but they're starting to extend this lead.
They're doing it by building it out, step by step, valuing each possession.
Jones against Morant. McDermott with the screen for Jones. Over James, and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on LeBron James. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Chicago.
They're unselfish. They're passing the ball well, setting up teammates, playing team basketball, and their focus.
And the other thing I've been impressed with, guys, is their assertiveness at attacking the paint, trying to hunt for those high percentage looks.
Williamson with the bucket.
How about the perseverance there, the extra effort on that offensive glass?
Jones kicks to Collins. Pass to McDermott. Driving to the basket. Kicks it out to Jones. Here's Vassell. Offline with his 3. Chicago leading by 9. Head dishes to Cauley Stein. Shoots over McDermott. The shot by Cauley Stein. No good. And it's Jones with the ball for San Antonio. Vassell. Outside, Jones. There's the pick. Passes it to Sohan. No good on the 3. Here's Chicago. They're on a 14-2 run here. The basket by Head.
Building up a big early lead, they have taken charge of this game.
Play calling has been fantastic. They've been a step ahead of the defense since the opening tip.
Now, here's Vassell. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him.
Aggressive play by Vassell in the paint. Getting himself a close range shot.
Here is Ed. Here's a follow. He trains the quick shot.
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
They came in prepared, focused, and really jumped on the other team early.
Jones finds Collins. Here's the 3. Vassell, no good.
It's so hard to keep the defense honest when you miss wide open looks like that.
A basket by Head.
Another good play. This is how they built the lead, calling on the right guys at the right time.
The reason why they stayed aggressive, and they have not let up this entire night. And at this point, I wouldn't expect them to.
The Spurs shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game. First one falls for them. Chicago making a switch here.
Shooting for your heart.
And so Jones nails both of them. Now here's Williamson. Outside, Jordan. And the rejection by Collins. And so it's Chicago. Up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. They've got their field goal percentage to thank for that. They've been... just tuning in. We've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. and taking a look at Chicago's performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
Yeah, in that first period, they looked to push in transition at every opportunity.
That's their mindset. Attack, attack, and attack some more. You're not going to beat them playing soft.
So with Smith sitting on the bench, this is the group Mike Malone has right now.
2 points.
Michael Jordan is out there with Head, and it's LeBron James. Then there's Cauley Stein, and it's Silas in at the four. Here's Richardson. Good D by LeBron. Chicago leading by 15. Here's Jordan. It's hauled in by Big Steve.
And you look at Jakob Poeltl, great touch and presence inside the paint. Can get you with a move or just power his way to the hoop.
Kicks it out to Richardson. This one for three. And Head pulls it down. Here's James, and the dunk by James.
Dunking is second nature to LeBron. All he needs is ideal positioning, and he's golden.
And we're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. And Greg Poeltl has so many options to score inside.
And that's why he's such an efficient scorer, Kevin. Very composed at the rim. Doesn't need a lot of time to get his shot off inside.
From deep, Jordan. And they recover it. Silas passes to Cauley Stein. Lays it up off the glass. Cauley Stein's got six.
Nice work inside by Cauley Stein. Great tools as a finisher.
Here's Primo. Guarded by Jordan.
First personal foul. First team foul. Substitution on the court.
Just about a minute and a half has gone by here in the second. The pass to length. Poeltl trying to get open. Again, the miss by the Spurs. Chicago leading by 19. Pass to Cauley Stein. Langford with a steal. Here's James. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
The power of LeBron. Even if you tried to give a hard foul, he'll go right through you.
And he'll be shooting his first free throw of the game here. And the free throw, no good. Now, here's Langford. James covering. Morant against Jones. To halt the run, it's deflected. Here's a follow. Here's McDaniel. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
Yeah, he's just one of those guys that never takes a possession off. McDaniel works and works at both ends of the court, and those second chance points all a product of his work ethic.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. Jones kicks to Poeltl. Pass to Johnson. From deep. And James pulls it down.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
You know what? This has always been a debate. Do you take the timeout, or do you let your guys try to fight through it?
Now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball. Langford with it. Working on James. Jones, no luck. Here's Chicago. They picked up 11 straight. On deep. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Morant. Both teams deciding to change it up.
Substitution on the court.
1:53 left here in the second. Jones dishes to Johnson. Jones against the follow. Collins kicks to Johnson. Off target with his three. Chicago leading by 23. Here's McDaniel. And they get it back. Here's Williamson. Here's Cauley Stein. Well, it was only a matter of time, but they finally get the bucket.
And with his vertical reach, you expect Cauley Stein to be a factor on the offensive glass.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. Doug McDermott, he's checked in for the Spurs. Shaq's checked in for Chicago. .12 left to play here in the second quarter. Jones in the post, guarded by Morant. And here we go. Williamson trying to free himself up. Here's McDaniel, and a good offensive board. And he gets the bucket. McDaniel's got his second basket of the game.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
And this is what happens when you start to break your opponent's spirit. The resistance is no longer there.
Chicago with the ball. 15 points in a row. A good run right now. Here's Morant. Here's O'Neal. And he finishes nicely on the layup.
The strength of O'Neal is otherworldly.
And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up with the Spurs. Nothing offensively yet from them in the second quarter. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. He's had four chances at the line, made them all. And the Spurs making a change here. Bates Diop's checked in, and so Jones nails both of them. Got a piece of it. It's stolen by Jones. And we have an intentional foul there, GA. Wish I could see why.
That one's pretty strange. I mean, no idea what got into his head right there.
At the line for your home.
That one is off.
Trey Jones. Two shots.
And he sinks the second. 11 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Morant outside. Three-pointer. The offensive rebound. O'Neal. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. And so it's Chicago. Ahead by 26 points as we get ready for the break. Their defense has been terrific in this game. And we've got more M2K Sports coming. After a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. What can you say, LeBron James? What an impressive effort today.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
This is his challenge, to continue to dominate, to help them try to close strong here in the second half.
McDermott in at the forward with Johnson as the other. Devin Vassell out there with Jones. And it's Poeltl in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's who Greg Popovich starts the second half with. Passes to Vassell. And here is Johnson. Feeds it to Poeltl. Good, and it's Johnson with the assist that time.
Operating the pick and roll well. Keldon Johnson keeping things simple and understanding how to execute.
Heads, shot is off. San Antonio with the ball. McDermott, no one around him. A three-pointer off the mark. LeBron, that's a two-pointer. The good-looking shot from the wing. That's 12 points for LeBron.
Putting consistent pressure on this defense. Just the threat of him out there makes this offense work.
Here's Jones. Poeltl. Great positioning on the putback.
Got to be on the lookout for Poeltl crashing the glass, using his body to wreck the defense on the boards.
There's the triple. Knocks down the three ball. Head's got 11 points.
High offensive IQ. He makes great reads and adjustments on the fly.
Jones, the pass to Vassell. And here is Johnson. Back to Vassell. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Greg, Devin Vassell came in as a 3-and-D type player, but he's grown beyond that.
He has added secondary ways to contribute on offense. Still, not a great shot creator, but can finish plays in a variety of ways to help his team.
Three-pointer. Head's shot is off.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Spins. Jones kicks to Vassell. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. McDermott can't get it to go. Chicago with the ball. Picked away. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Vassell, the pass to Jones. McDermott down low, working on James. Three on the clock. Vassell kicks to Johnson. From outside, off the mark. Johnson's gone 1-4 from the field. From deep three-point range. And it's Morant missing. And it's the Spurs ball. Vassell, the pass to Jones. Here's McDermott. On the wing, Johnson. Outside, Jones. San Antonio needs to get off a shot here. San Antonio, again missing. Head kicks to Cauley-Stein. And the three ball is good. Cauley-Stein's got 11 points.
He's an asset in helping space the floor. He has tremendous touch from range.
On the wing, Johnson from deep. And that comes off the assist by Jones.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
How often do we see this these days? Clubs answer each other from range.
And you're asking for more trouble than you can handle if you're going to let him just roam free from beyond the arc.
Jones kicks to Johnson. McDermott for three. Chicago grabs the miss. McDaniel's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Hit. Rebound San Antonio. On its way from McDermott for 2. That shot off. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. From deep. The shot, no good.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
You know what another option is? Just give the ball up. Let someone else make a play.
And it's blocked. And they're able to recover. Johnson kicks to Vassell. Just 5 on the clock. McDermott for 3. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jakob Poeltl. That's foul number 2 for him. And that kind of stifling effort on defense needs another look.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
That will count. Unable to get that one. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. And Chicago running away. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
It's just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball. And how about the perfect delivery?
Execution. This is what you practice every day. These guys are professionals. Beautiful play.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. So with Smith sitting on the bench, this is the group Mike Malone has right now. O'Neal is out there with Williamson. And there's Bradley Beal. And it's Birdsong in at the point. Here's Birdsong. Offensive rebound. And O'Neal gets it to go.
It's a tall challenge trying to contain Shaq, especially when he's operating close to the basket.
The pass to Bates Dion. Here's Collins. And it's sent back by O'Neal. Here's Silas, covered by Wesley. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Chicago.
It's just a passing clinic from them in this game. Solid communication and unselfish play all around.
And also, they continue to take advantage on the offensive glass. Those extra possessions paying off in second chance points.
Luther Head has checked in for Chicago. Jones drives in, pass to Bates Dion. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
This is who you want leading that play. A sure passer with great awareness.
Silas passes to Head. But Trey buries the long-range jumper. Head's got 9 points here in the second half.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
This was obviously a focal point coming out of the break. Looks smart when the shots are going down. He goes to the bounce pass there. Nice rhythm at the end of the play.
Collins has gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Head passes to O'Neal. Bank in off the glass.
Nice touch there near the hoop.
Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. Jones looking for an opening. Pass to Wesley. It's blocked by Shaq.
And the aggressiveness on display here from O'Neal. Terrific at turning shots away with that size and length.
And he comes up with the deuce. Birdsong's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And the D getting outworked there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
For some reason, blocking out has become a lost art, and that's the result you'll get.
Just strong work defensively there in the low post. You gotta be tough down in the paint.
He did a nice job of keeping him off the block, didn't let him get deep post position.
Late reaction defensively. He quickly takes advantage, grows their lead.
You can't afford to give him space. Those kinds of mistakes have been the story of this game.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. Here's San Antonio. Wesley with the ball. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Collins passes to Primo. Here's Wesley. And nothing has fallen for him right now. And so it's Williamson with it. He brings it up for Chicago. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. And they'll get another chance.
Wow, another opportunity. Just everything going their way. Pretty much the story of this game.
Six to shoot. The three from Morant. It's good from long range.
Heavy incoming from beyond the arc, a key part of their initiative this entire fourth quarter.
Interesting approach coming down the stretch, looking to rack up points in chunks.
Primo, San Antonio again missing. Chicago with the ball. Silas passes to Head, pulls it up. They get it back. Williamson kicks to Head, passes it to Silas. Fires from deep. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. And Morant gets it to go.
Morant, such a quick thinker. He doesn't hesitate on the catch and shoot.
...56 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. He tries for three. Shot's good by Wesley.
Mano y mano. This is where it can get a little personal.
Sometimes it's a matter of pride answering back with a three of his own.
Shaq with the bucket.
He's not looking at the score. He's staying focused and he's staying active.
There's two things they rely on him for: being competitive and bringing energy.
Wesley with the ball. Guarded now by Shaq.
And you gotta like that they found something positive here, something that maybe carryovers into the next game.
They put together some great possessions here at the end. It's a shame they could have used this run much earlier.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. And the pass to Sohan. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Here is Ed. Covered by Wesley. Here's Head. Missed. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin.
Baby, she. I made that. I tell her. She wanna tell me she love me. I tell her I'm cool, so I tell her. Yeah. My little. Nah. She didn't want to hate me. She love me. Yeah. Like Dre too forward, Dre too bait, Dre too nuff.
Like Dre too nuff.
Keep on assuming I don't correct. I call you bluff.
Like I call you bluff.
Y'all think they're nice.
Y'all think they're nuff.
You ain't buff.
Like you ain't buff.
You looking rough.
Like you looking rough.
So just give me the stuff.
Like give me the stuff.
She moving forward, she ain't important. Give me the love.
Like give me the love.
Like I want something you got for me, baby. What's up?
Like,
baby,
what's up?
I wanna, baby, let me.
Oh, she don't know what I'm about. Let me give you a head start.
Let me just give you the
yo, Dre the best.
Dre the best.
Say it with chest. She ain't under the rest.
No,
no, she ain't feeling no stress.
Nah.
I'm like, come here, baby, sit on my lap, run your hand through my dreads.
She ain't not feeling me. Sit, Felix, come like frenemy. Like Oliver Twist, she. Yeah, get set, play ready, we steady be. She special miss, what's the recipe? I give her like four, give me 10 of it.
She want the best of me. And pray that she.
She don't wanna with my squad. She wanna love on me only. She don't wanna love on nobody.
Love on nobody.
No.
Thanks for tuning in this Wednesday. 2K Sports presents the NBA. I'm Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Richard Jefferson alongside. David Aldridge is with us from the floor tonight. Now let's take a look at the starters for New Orleans. Up front, it's Williamson at the four and Valanciunas at the five. The guard pair are Graham and McCollum. And it's Ingram in at the three. And for Chicago, Morant is out there with a flower. Then there's Cauley Stein. Then it's McDaniel, and it's LeBron in at the three. Now here's Graham. Williamson is screen on Morant. Graham dishes to Williamson. Puts it up from seven, and the rejection by Cauley Stein. James outside. And finished off by LeBron.
This is classic LeBron leaping off the floor for a powerful dunk.
McCollum against the Flalo. Now here's McCollum. Not a lot of room. The layup missed. And here's Moran. He'll bring it up for Chicago. And the three off target.
And you look at the way Ingram can get off his shot. When he gets to his spots, there's just no stopping him. Very few players can create like he can.
And that one's good. Ingram.
And we talk about court awareness. There, McCollum doing a beautiful job spotting the open man.
A creator indeed, and the name you always hear, Greg, with Ingram as a comparison, Kevin Durant.
And that's about as fair a comp as you'll find. Ingram is special with how he can rise up over defenders with that shot. Makes him a lethal weapon late in the game.
Well, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, when he gets engaged this early in the game, it's bad news for the defense. He can roll this start throughout the rest of the game.
Now a flop. Cauley Stein finds Morant. Shoots over Graham. Zion Williamson grabs the miss. Ingram with it. Now guarded by a flop. And it's McCollum in the corner. Hits the jumper in space.
And you can't give McCollum any space. Always a threat to pull the trigger.
Here's LeBron. And the dunk by LeBron.
And if you try to block his shot, you risk getting posterized because he is good at using that height to his advantage.
They double him with LeBron. Here's Williamson. The basket is good off the assist from Graham.
Powerful move there by Williamson. He's not afraid to throw his weight around in the paint.
The three from Morant drains it from beyond the arc. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Yeah, you look at the lead changes. Six already.
Graham, the pass to McCollum. Beyond the arc. Hits the 3.5. McCollum's got 5 points so far.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my revenge.
Now Ingram. Following the miss by John Morant from deep. Graham with the ball. He's picked up by Morant. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense in anticipation there to stop it. Oh, boy, looks like he was injured there.
Yeah, it looks like he's in real pain. Definitely a concern right now.
Look, I'm no doctor, and I know that might be a surprise to a lot of you people, but look, that looked pretty harsh, and he's certainly going to have to miss some extended time.
So Chicago ends up going with the new group, a basket by Head.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
Now here's Jones. Lewis with the three. The rebound by Jordan. Passes it to Silas. There's the three. That one's not going to go. So the Pelicans will take it the other way. And Temple kicks to Lewis. The pass to Hayes. And stolen by Williamson. And here's the fast break. Jordan wide open. It's rebounded by New Orleans. 58 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Down low, here's Nance.
Oh my goodness, what a play.
Nance is special. How easy is it for him to make the spectacular look routine?
Let's it go with a three. Rebounded by Temple.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just lucky he was off.
Lewis passes to Nance. Over Williamson. Two free throws.